Welcome back, guys. We're on Viaduct now, Pro Viaduct, watching mGn take on TI. TI taking Gullywash 5-0. This is round two of the OzFortress Winter League Season 10, Division 6, round three. Trigger Spasm, I'm following him at the moment. He went absolutely off for mGn in Viaduct, in Gullywash, sorry. And does unfortunately go down as one of the first kills in this one. Anzo gets Knight though, and it looks like it's TI all over middle point, playing as the red side. Butch taking a little bit of fire there, and he's been spotted by a scout, but he gets the comms out there, protected nicely by his soldiers there. Lambda picking up Anzo. Deadshot goes down to Lambda also, so that should be an opportunity for the mGn guys to push back onto middle here. Oh, Wumbo's been caught out too. Lambda getting him. Lambda's absolutely smashing face at the moment. So only 22 seconds taken off the clock for TI's cap there. And now mGn have taken... Oh, but the sticky crits. Lambda goes down. And it goes down to a direct pipe hit. Tiberium gets holograsm from somewhere else. But Tall is forced out as Yalhos is under fire. Trigger Spasm taking him on. But unfortunately, a dead shot was there to stop him. And he goes down. So... it'll be pretty even in terms of time, but TI will retake middle surely as Knight and Butch are forced out. Butch is nice and safe, I say that, as Tall comes back in, puts some more damage down. Butch very low on health now, but did survive. 52% Uber. Wumbo switching over the Heavy. Now, Heavy has been absolutely devastating on Viaduct in about two seasons ago. As Anna gets right up into Deadshot's face and takes him down. Meanwhile, Tiberium is holding off on the right-hand side, holding off the entire rest of the mGn team, it seems. Oh, there's a sniper for mGn. That is... who is that? That's Holograsm trying to snipe the Heavy on the point. Great counter to a Heavy. Might need to go up. But in come Knight and Butch. They've popped the Uber. Normal Uber will beat a crit, and the crits are out, but they're not doing a hell of a lot at the moment because they're mostly aimed at that Uber. Butch does eventually go down, but Tall and Enzo have gone down in response, so mGn lose their medic, not great. Yahos nearly went down too, actually, but they did force TI off the point, so TI down to 1 minute 51, mGn down to 2 minutes and 14 already, and ticking, so... TI will be looking to push straight back in as soon as they can. Deadshot's having a look. He's not encountering a hell of a lot of resistance on that point. You kind of want to be on the point so you've got the higher ground. Oh, Deadshot, lovely jump up to get Knight and Trigger Spasm with one single rocket, softened up ably by Tall and Wumbo. Deadshot getting right up into... I didn't see who it was. I think it was might have been Anna there. But TI already retaking that middle point without needing their Uber advantage either. So Butch died again. He's only up 3% Uber. Yahos has just recently hit 100% Uber. Wumbo way up on top takes down Anna. And it looks like the mGn guys are trying to push in on the left-hand side. It is frantic Viaduct action. Nice back and forwards players. Butch and Lambda combined to get Tiberium, but Tall with the crit picks up Butch, Knight, and Lambda in response. Holograsm gets Wumbo, and he's found Yahos. If he can pick up Yahos here, it will be a nice advantage for him. He does. Yahos getting one Ubersaw hit in on him, but it was not enough. Holograsm had plenty of health. Oh, pardon me. And it looks like mGn will try to push back in on that left-hand side. 30% Uber advantage for Butch here. Yahos still not up. Tall gets Anna, but then... Deadshot goes down to Knight, so it's the demo men going off here. Oh, but it's Tall. He's caught Knight unawares, but Holograsm is putting the pressure down on him also. Holograsm escapes alive just. Lambda getting Tall in the end. Trigger Spasm getting Wumbo as Tiberium picks Lambda up in response. So mGn retake the middle point. Only 45 seconds left needed for TI to hold that point. 1 minute and 45 almost for the mGn guys, so they're at a bit of a disadvantage. And Deadshot, he shouldn't be allowed to put that much pressure on the point. Get closer, mGn. You can't let them just edge their way on like that. It's hard getting up that hill, especially for soldiers. Oh, it's Deadshot finds Butch, and Rocket jumps after him, but a Holograsm with a nice shot to hit him midair there. But meanwhile, TI have retaken the middle point. They did have a big Uber advantage, so maybe that's what mGn were worried about. I'm not sure if they did have a big Uber advantage or if... oh, it's the crits again. Another triple kill. Knight, Butch, and who else was it? I think it might have been Anna, I'm not sure. All going down, but now Lambda is the only one up. And it is looking bad for mGn in this first round of Viaduct. 16 seconds left on the clock for TI to take it. And They're doing what they can, but with only 10 seconds left, he's not looking good. Butch runs in, but gets sniped by Anzo. Knight gets Anzo in response, and Anna gets Wumbo. There is some pressure on the point. They've got a times one cap. Yahos picks up a kill on Holograsm with his crossbow again. That's the second one he's got of that, and he's picked up a bonus or one too tonight, so he's earning a few kills for his team as medic. But TI do take that first round. With 1 minute and 17 seconds left on the clock for the mGn guys, not a thrashing by any means, but I'm sure they'll be hoping to do better in round two. Let's have a look at maybe not Lambda, he's very low on health. Oh, Trigger Spasm with the Spy. I struggle with Spy at the start here because it's almost impossible not to run into somebody. You've got to grab... Yeah, there he goes down. You've got to grab the ammo to keep yourself invisible, and it just puts you right in the face of the enemy, and they're almost always going to notice you. I've tried it a fair few times myself, and I'm not a fan. Holograsm also went down in that initial exchange. The only other one to go down, and TI rather easily capped middle point, which is fair enough after mGn lost two. Do they still have the crits, Krieg? Yes, they do. But the Uber is almost up, but it goes down. They need to realize the threat that it poses to them and just back off. You know they've got a crit, so they're going to get to Uber before you. Put your expendable classes at the front so that they have to pop the Uber if they're going to push on you, and just keep your medic way, way at the back. Keep him way back at spawn if you have to. He was on about 98% Uber there, Butch. And if he'd managed to get that last couple of Uber, it would have gone horribly for TI, because, as we all know, a normal Uber beats a Crits Krieg every time. Meanwhile, in comes Lambda, picking up Tiberian there. Knight gets Yahos, so there is the medic down for TI, but Butch has had to fall out. He's on half health. Times 4 cap, though, for mGn on the point. It's mostly Scout plus, I think, a Pain Train Soldier. Knight gets Tall, so Knight getting the better of Tall that time in the demo versus demo action. TI trying to defend the point, mostly trying to get Butch, I believe, but unable to do so. Wumbo going down to the combined fire of about five different players from mGn. So this time Butch is using the crits key too. Oh, maybe that's why he was so close on Uber. Maybe he was hoping to get the crits first and get the jump on Yahos and whoever he was Ubering. So, okay, maybe that was a good way of countering it by them. Apologies, mGn. I probably misunderstood what you were trying to do before. And now Butch is roaming with Knight, definitely looking to get the jump on somebody. But here comes the correct counter by TI, getting somebody and trying to pop that Uber first. They're just absolutely mainstreaming their way towards Butch. They've got him in their sights, and they do not care about anybody else at the moment. But Butch is using his teammates to great effect to protect himself. So, and mGn, as I speak, tick over and take the lead from TI. Yahos does have 100% Uber, though. Probably still has that crit. Oz, Butch takes a bit of damage there. In fact, they did have to pop the crits, Krieg, so Yahos is going to come in with the clean-up crits. They should do it, but there's one scout jumping around. That was Trigger Spasm. Took a fair while for Tool to get Trigger Spasm, but he does get Knight after that and should pick up Wumbo, I believe. No, that's Holograsm. Oh, Yahos! Being too much of a smart-ass. Does get the Ubersaw hit in on Holograsm, who does then go down to Tool, but Holograsm says, "You're going to hit me with your Ubersaw? You're in killing range, boy, of my scatter gun," and does just that, taking down the Yahos. So 30% Uber advantage for Butch at the moment. Yahos still 3 seconds away from respawning, as this time it's mGn to sneak their way onto the point. Very good work there by them. They've got numbers there. They're doing it cautiously. That's fine. They're doing it. Oh, the jumping soldier jumps straight onto middle. There's no medic there for him to get. Tiberium goes down to the nice work there by Lambda to protect his medic. Never really in any doubt. Trigger Spasm doesn't want to run into spawn. Ooh, he's lagging a little bit on my screen. So look at his ping. Oh, yes, 111. And Knight with 115, so maybe they're playing from New Zealand or somewhere. As Yahos, 55% Uber. Butch did go down. Who got him? It must have been a sniper kill. I totally missed it. But I did hear a sniper shot in the background, so maybe it was the sniper shot that got him. That is going to be a big problem for mGn. This is where you kind of want to make a play for Yahos. See if you can just pop him and give the Uber advantage back to your own medic. You want to get him before he gets that crits. Alternatively, after he's got the crits ready, you could always just pop the Uber. But You don't want to let them make the push onto you, as that's probably Deadshot. He loves to do the jump in. Knight not able to get into him. Oh, yes, he did. No, Tor went down to Knight. Holograsm got Tiberium. So, back onto middle point to defend it. They got it to two-player kill advantage. That's good work by them. Yahos went down at some point, or maybe just popped his Uber, I'm not sure. But he's got 0% at the moment. Anzo picks up Anna with a nice headshot, but Knight gets Deadshot in response, and in comes Lambda to clean up. Oh, he only cleans up Yahos. Big kill, though, but Tor gets him immediately afterwards. Trigger spasm right into the back of Tor there. Great roaming by him. He's going to get back onto the point. He's seen a sniper, but that sniper is going to do absolutely nothing to him so long as he doesn't poke his head out. Oh, he has to poke his head out because I didn't see that Tiberium had jumped onto him. Now, Trigger Spasm can totally harass the sniper away here. Nice long-range scatter. Oh, no. Needed to take a bit more cover there. If you're not putting constant damage down on the sniper, it's not going to work for you. As TI make a desperation push for last, but they are not in time, and they lose this round by 1 minute and 10 seconds, which I think is almost exactly what mGn lost the first round by. So, one round apiece here, and this certainly looks like a better map for mGn, as they are going to be pushing back in the middle. I will follow Holograsm, who is going to be sniping it up. He's up on the top right. Oh, he had a pick on the med there, but does not pick him up. No even body shot damage. Now there's rockets flying constantly in his direction. That can actually open up and, well, provide an opening for your team. But no, Anzo and Tall able to put enough damage down elsewhere to pick up. Oh my god. In very quick order, Deadshot, Anzo, Tall, Tiberian, and Wumbo all picked up a kill. And finally, Lambda goes down to Anzo too. So, an absolute whitewash there by TI on that first middle rollout. They will be in a very good position to hold this point, middle point, for quite a while. Some long range pipes and stickies go onto the point there, but not. Yes, no. Anzo, Jahos did pop his crits, and he does go down to Knight. Knight picks up both Yahos and Wumbo. Great work there by him. Holograsm is going to chase Tall out here. He finds Tiberian. Somehow gets him with a single. Oh, beautiful roaming there by Holograsm again. He's doing a lot to earn himself some man of the match points in this round, as Lambda forces his way onto the point. Exactly the right thing he should be doing, and exactly anticipates where that soldier is coming from. That's Deadshot, I suspect, who has a rocket jumped to the health pack behind him. Jumps back in, but Lambda's waiting for him again. He jumps onto Butch. Can he get him? No, Butch. Nice maneuvering there to avoid almost all of that damage there. He's on 40% Uber, 15% ahead of Yahos. Is he still using the crits? He is using the crits, so long as he keeps healing injured people, whether it be grinding or just natural skirmish damage, which TI are more than happy to put out at the moment, as one of the scouts tries to push in. Both the scouts try to push in. One was just a distraction for the other one. They're going in. They've popped the crits. It hasn't killed anybody yet, but Anna did get one kill from on Anzo. The heavy comes out, not the best one to crits when the team has already seen that you've popped and they've already backed way out. Tall going down there, and Lambda went down in response. Anna picks up Tiberium. Butch has to back off for some health. Let's have a look at some of the TI guys. They've backed way back to spawn, within spawn even. Yahos on 100% Uber comes out now that he's found Tall. I suspect that is where the crits are going to come from. Let's get into first person perspective so we can see the destruction firsthand. He's waiting. His teammates are calling when they are there. Some very long range. I feel he might have popped that a little early. He does get Holograsm. Picks up Trigger Spasm also, but not the two he was looking for, I'm sure. He would have been wanting Butch and probably Knight. Meanwhile, they are getting a lot of kills, though. Tall does take a fair bit of damage from someone. I didn't see where that came from. But the entire mGn team is dead, so maybe they didn't pop it too early. Maybe a couple of scout kills allowed the rest of the team to just collapse on the heavies and maybe swamp them from sides. Who knows? Holding well forward now, TI. Let's have a look at Anzo. He's sneakily hiding up behind on the... He wants to drop to get him. No, he doesn't. He picks up Lambda, who is, came out completely unawares. Oh, Butch is surely going to be in his sights. No, he's going to go for Knight first. He gets him with some big help from Deadshot there. Comes around to protect his medic. Well, goes back to his medic for health, and in doing so, protects him from the attacking soldier in Anna. Anna does go down to Anzo, but Anzo goes down to Holograsm immediately afterwards, and mGn have picked up a few kills there and will be able to push back onto the point. Still very even. TI... Oh, here come the crits! They get Butch! They get Lambda! Holograsm really wants Yahos here! Oh, he must have been low. Where is he? No, actually, Yahos wasn't low at all, so the scattergun blasts I saw that I thought were on target apparently were not. So TI just using their crits a little better than mGn here. Scoreboard times are actually very even, but surely TI will be able to hold it for quite a while here. Probably mGn just want to push without Ubers here. Try to get some... Oh, yes, as Knight may well have caught out Yahos and Tall here. No, they managed to back out Tiberian and Enzo very low, but Yahos and Tall get out quite easily. Oh, the Heavy is there. Wombo taking some pipes, though, from Knight, I suspect. Does not get out. Anna jumping in to get him. Butch wants to heal his scout, but shouldn't leave. Yes. Oh, dear. You need to be watching yourself. The scout will come to you. Yeah. Medic more important than scout. Keep yourself alive, and if you're not watching where the enemy are, it's all too easy for that to happen, as you can probably figure out. Butch did go down there. mGn trying to push their way on the mid. 20 seconds on the clock for TI. They've got numbers there, and it does not look like mGn will be able to take this one. Another quite close round. Deadshot getting right up into the Butch Lambda combo there, I think it is. Lambda goes down. Butch went down just before him, and that will be quite an easy hold here in the end for TI. As almost the entire mGn team is dead at the moment. So 2-1 in favour of TI. Will mGn be able to find that response again? I might watch Deadshot. He's been jumping in a lot so far tonight. So let's see what he does on rollout here. Now Deadshot's playing as scout. Wombo not playing a scout anymore. They're switching the classes around just to confuse me, I'm sure. Lovely long-range scattergun blast there by Deadshot. Popped up in the air by Tall to get Trigger Spasm. Oh! As Butch gets spotted there, Enzo and Deadshot combining again. They're doing very well. Maybe this was a very good... Oh! Deadshot not quite getting there. Anna gets him, but does take himself out in the process at that very close blast range. Holograsm playing as the sniper. I haven't really seen him get anybody yet. Oh, Yahos is down, though, and I did not see who got him, so maybe that can be attributed to the sniper. I'm not sure. TI, Tiberian. Oh, he gets right into Butch. He needs protection. He needs protection. He gets protection, but he did take a lot of damage. The health pack is right there, though, so he'll be quite happy in the end. Get the feeling maybe mGn need to just defend a little bit further forward off the... Oh, Deadshot picks up Knight with the sniper shot, so good work there by him. Wombo gets a little bit of assist from Lambda to rocket jump his way out of there. Lambda providing some extra explosive acceleration, but he is quite fine. So mGn not wanting to push in yet because Holograsm is very low on health and had to back all the way off to supply cabinet. In come the crits! Oh! Tiberian goes down! Oh, but Lambda goes down in response. Tall Sneaky Trap picking him up. Wombo gets Butch, and that is the end of that little crits krieg spree. Yahos did pop his crits. There's not a hell of a lot left to use it on. Anna goes down. Anzo and picks up both Knight and Holograsm. But still, TI, 1 minute and 46 left on the clock, and mGn... Yah! Beautiful work by Trigger Spasm, taking on 4, getting Yahos before going down. He did his job. And Anzo, oh, Deadshot picks up Butch though in response, so both Deadshot and, who was it, Holograsm? No, Trigger Spasm, sorry, doing the job for their teams, getting the medics, but probably in the end in TI's favour, they're in control of the point, so even Stevens is in their favour so long as they defend forward on that point, which they are doing. They are in the right spot, and as they can see, or as mGn can see, it is very hard to push in against a team that knows where you are. As Wombo jumps right into the face again of the mGn team, gets Wombo, Lambda, still hasn't gone down. In fact, he's still behind Knight, who doesn't even know he's there. Tall getting Holograsm, Wombo getting Knight, and Wombo's going to rocket jump back to his medic. Why hasn't he been playing as soldier all the time? He's doing great. Anzo gets Trigger Spasm off camera. Anna backs off for some health. But just the constant pressure from TI here. Just keeping the mGn guys from getting anywhere near the point. This is looking to be the most one-sided round we've had so far tonight. As I think mGn just really need to get their team grouped up for one final push at the point here. It's going to be pretty hard for them. Yahos has 100% Uber. They've got to pop that Uber, get onto the point. In the next 10 seconds, doesn't look like it's going to happen. Where is Yahos? I want to see what he does with this last second Kritzkrieg. Apparently nothing, because I have a bit of a bug with the Demo Man there, probably because I alt-tabbed before. They do make a push on, but here comes the crits now. Could have popped it a little bit earlier, I reckon. But in the end, TI will team down mGn and take the fourth round of Viaduct with 3 minutes remaining on mGn's clock. So a flawless victory there. Well, as flawless as you can get without actually losing any members at any point. So 3-1 in favour of TI. We should see the team swap. Let's have a quick look at the scoreboard while they do that. Lambda on 39 points for mGn. He has been doing very well. Knight on 33, not too far behind him. And then the rest are very even on 26, 25 and 23. Meanwhile, on TI, we have Tall on 67 points, way ahead of Anzo. Unsurprisingly, because I think pretty much every single time the crits has been up for Yahos, it has been popped on him. So that is probably why the discrepancy has been coming from. Anzo has been doing very well too. 49 points. 31 for Wumbo. I would have thought he'd been a bit higher. He's been doing very well. Deadshot also doing very well with those dives earlier. Maybe they switched it actually because they feel that Deadshot is a better sniper and they'd rather be down a scout than a soldier. I suspect that is probably why they swapped those classes, but Wumbo has certainly been showing that he can face soldier if needed. Alright, mGn have readied up as we will go into the fifth round of Koth Viaduct. We are currently 3-1 in favour of TI. I'm following Knight this time. Jumps straight on the point. Exactly opposite him is Tall. Tall getting the better of that initial exchange. Not by much, though. Ah, but the rocket jumping soldier of Tiberian gets straight into him. Good comms there, I suspect, by the mGn guys. Getting the kill as... Butch is on... looks like both of them are using the Kritzkrieg again. No, Yahos with the Uber charge. And yet, despite that, is ahead in grind, or in Uber charge, from Butch. So, oh no, he does still have the Kritzkrieg. Sorry, I was completely fooled. And it looks like, though, that Lambda and Butch will clean up. Oh, Butch is trapped here by Deadshot. No, Wumbo, sorry. Wumbo goes down to Anna immediately afterwards, but it looks like mGn should have domination over this middle point. Tiberian just escaping with his life. Way back to spawn, which is probably not a bad thing because he got there just at the same time as the respawn wave came through. And it looks like TI will just sit back and grind that Uber. They know they have an Uber advantage. Butch on 14% Uber, Yahos on 54% Uber. As Lambda gets Tall, but Anzo and Tiberian get Anna and Lambda. Knight gets Anzo in response, so it's two down apiece. What will we see? Wumbo goes down to Knight. Trigger spasm as sniper far right, just watching that that side passageway mostly. But that's not where the action is at the moment. Okay, Yahos has his 100% crits, so let us follow. If I can find him. Tall, there's Tall, just in time to see Holograsm. Knight go down. Butch will surely die now. Yes, there goes Butch. So just getting it too quickly and using it very efficiently. Immediately upon getting it, they've gotten on there. Wumbo gets Lambda. Anna gets one in response. And it looks like it'll be TI just chasing the mGn guys right out. So TI have been very good at this. When they've lost the point, they've backed right off. They've grouped up. They've gotten the Uber, all those sorts of things. And they've made a play when they've been ready to make a play. mGn, I feel, have been maybe feeling the pressure a bit more and they've been trying to get on and do something even when they don't really have the players there. As one of the rocket jumping soldiers gets up into... That's Tiberian, but he does go down. Anna getting him. Holograsm goes down. Knight goes down from Anzo's sniper rifle body shot there. And the rocket jumping Tall, will he get anybody in there? Doesn't look like it. Can't even see where he went. Lambda putting some rockets down on the players on the point. Oh, snipers walked way forward onto the point. Not a huge fan of that tactic as the sniper. If they jump you, you're basically a free kill. As I cannot seem to find anybody who is actually doing anything. Knight's taking damage. Holograsm, let's have a look at him. He's going to be looking for to put some pressure on the scout moving up there. Anna gets Wumbo. Will that be the opportunity? Oh, Knight goes down to Tiberian, but then immediately goes down to Lambda. Holograsm, oh, nicely placed rocket there by Deadshot, picking him up. Lambda's still up there. I think he might have a Deadshot coming up behind him. Yes, he does, but he's got Butch on him. Why didn't Deadshot go for Butch? Maybe he was out of rockets. Too many jumps. Oh, Butch is in trouble here, but it looks like Deadshot will get out. Will he crater? No, he won't. And he picks up the health, so he's okay. Retreating out on the right-hand side there. No, he's going to jump back in on Butch, and he should get him. No! Lambda getting him very quickly there. I suspect he had help. Non-credited help, but now Butch with these 100% crits is going to go in and pop it. He's popped it. Bang! There goes Tiberian. Wumbo went down off camera. Yahos has popped his also, but Yahos and Tall goes down. Surely it was popped on Tall. Knight goes down to Anzo's sniper rifle. Yahos goes down to Knight. Didn't need the crits to finish him off. And mGn take middle point again. They've got numbers here. They should be able to hold. Anzo goes down, but Deadshot gets one in response. So stay on middle, mGn. You're still good. You're still good. Was that a spy? No, it was not. I'm seeing things. Butch holding on the left-hand side. He needs to get that Uber grinding. Where's Yahos? Yahos isn't getting his ground either, though. He's found somebody who can grind him, though. Will they grind? No, they'll content themselves with just healing injured players. Probably a smart thing to do. As TI push into middle here, Butch is taking damage, but he's still alive. He's almost up to 100% Uber. Picks up the health pack. They should go back in on this. TI did take middle point, though. Perhaps a little bit too easily. Oh, yes, Knight gets Deadshot. Deadshot had snuck in behind, but now Butch has got players all over him. He's got out the Uber source, surely. Where is it? Ah, yes! He combines with Lambda to protect himself from Wumbo. Four players down for TI. Three players down as Trigger Spasm goes down. Anzo getting him. And Anzo is still hiding in behind. But, Butch! What got him there? I didn't see what got him. It was some sort of explosive class. But mGn did manage to take the point. As Deadshot having to back out there. Get some medic loving on that far side. Knight trying to protect the left-hand side. Up against Tall, is forced out. The stickies are right next to him. He might be in a... Oh, he's caught Yahos. Yahos is split off from his soldiers, but Tall and Wumbo have gone in and picked up Lambda and Holograsm anyway. They're all over the point. Knight's going in. Why is he going... Oh, because the point is about to be capped out. So 26 seconds as the GGs go up. Well done by the TI boys, taking that, I think it was 4-1 in the end. Guys are starting to leave, let's have I missed most of the scores, but let's quickly go to a recap of it. So, Gullywash won 5-0 in pretty convincing fashion, really, by the TI guys over mGn, but Koth Viaduct, a much closer story, even though the score was 4-1 in the end. All bar one of those rounds was actually quite close, so TI can be a little disappointed that they didn't manage to pull out a better scoreline there, but good work by them anyway. Man of the match, well, it's got to go to one of the TI players. Really, it was quite even contributions again. I mean, Tall obviously getting a lot of points with those crits kriegs all the time, and that was one of the deciding factors in the match tonight. It just seemed to take the mGn guys a little bit too long to figure out how to counter that Kritzkrieg that Yahos kept pulling out there. I think once he went Kritzkrieg, he never went back. So he obviously realized he had a bit of the advantage, maybe a bit more practice with it over Butch and his team. A bit more practice. Although that said, when Butch and his team were using it, they actually did quite well. So good work by him. Trigger Spasm for the mGn guys was very good too. But I'm probably going to give... Oh, it's a pretty hard one to actually give out Man of the Match tonight. Tall did do very well. I mean, you can stuff up using the crit, so maybe I will give it to him after all. Although, Wumbo certainly did well playing those multi-roles.
I was pretty impressed by him also, and Anzo was pretty devastating too. So Tall with the man of the match, but a couple of honourable mentions, I suppose, there for another couple of players. We here at GameStar would like to thank our sponsors, OzGamers, for all the latest news, reviews, downloads, and anything that is gaming for both consoles and PCs. Head on over to www.ozgamers.com. This has been a GameStar presentation. If you would like to see more esports action, head on over to www.gamestar.com. That's STAH. And check out all these streams there. It's not actually up at the moment, but hopefully we'll be back up shortly. Good night all. Have fun.